The Ethical Psychic, a beginner's guide to healing with integrity, avoiding unethical encounters, and using your gifts for good. For psychics, hoodoos, witches, brujas, and healers. By Jennifer Lisa Vest, PhD. Narrated by Cindy Kay. Published by North Atlantic Books. For my mother, Michael Lee Davis, who was a psychic before it was okay to be one, and who warned me about the dangers of this work. I was listening, Mom. And it harms none. Do what ye will. Witches read. Preface. I began writing this guidebook in the second month of 2017, less than 2 weeks after the inauguration of one of the most unpopular presidents in United States history. The country was in turmoil. Record numbers of people were taking to the street to protest, and a majority of the population was concerned that we were in the midst of a moral turning point. The greatest critique being made of the U.S. president and his cabinet in 2017 was neither a political nor a policy critique. It was a moral one. The world was terrified by the possible consequences that could result from a presidency that lacked moral standards. At this time, I was teaching a class called Conscious Psychic, which I first began teaching in 2012, in my living room, to a handful of students under the title, Develop Your Sixth Sense to Shift Your Consciousness. I would explain to my students that my class was different from other psychic development classes because I wasn't just teaching them how to develop their gifts. I was teaching them how to develop their gifts in service to the planet. As such, I frequently spoke about ethics. Some of my students groaned and complained about this frequent emphasis. Others just chalked it up to old habits dying hard. I was, after all, a former professor of philosophy who had taught ethics to college students for many years. Maybe I just couldn't help myself. While some students appreciated the ethical content, others tired of it and went in search of easygoing teachers who would teach them how to cast spells and other self-serving skills. Over the years, I had the misfortune of seeing some of my spellcasting former students turn to filthy magic or the dark arts and other abusive psychic practices. They had rebelled against my teachings because I had often warned against pursuing such practices. Their decision to jettison ethics resulted in exactly what I had cautioned against. This confirmed my belief that teaching students how to be ethical psychics was of paramount importance. Over the years, I've taught a number of courses in the psychic and healing arts, including mediumship, medical intuition, Reiki, intuitive healing energetics, Akashic records, and others. In each of these, I emphasized the importance of ethics. And as time went on, I became convinced of the need to collect all of my teachings into a book. A person can be gifted, but use their gifts in an unethical manner. This book will address this problem and provide ethical guidelines. Psychically gifted persons have a responsibility to those without gifts. There are limits as to how psychic gifts should be employed. Just because a person can read someone's mind doesn't mean they should. It is not ethical to use one's psychic gifts to seduce. And while there is nothing wrong with making large sums of money using one's psychic gifts, there are conditions that must be met when doing so. In recent years, there has been an increase in the number of people claiming to have psychic psi gifts and wanting to develop or share them. At the same time, interest in all topics related to psi has grown. More and more people consult psychics, mediums, medical intuitives, life coaches, spiritual advisors, and healers. Increasingly, people are leaving traditional religions to join non-denominational spiritual bodies. More and more people are also using integrative and holistic health practitioners. And there has been a surge in interest in books published on esoteric and psi topics. People are bringing their most pressing life and health problems to psychically gifted practitioners of various kinds instead of to establishment Western healers. There is evidence of a planetary shift in consciousness. So many factors are coming together now. The planetary shift in consciousness, political upheaval, the increased codependent needs of the general population, and an increase in the number of light workers developing their gifts. Now is the time. All these factors make it more important than ever that psychics behave ethically and that standards be established for psychic work. How does the average psychic learn how to be ethical? I teach my students how to be ethical, but my classes cannot reach the growing number of light workers developing every day. This guidebook was written to assist the many aspiring and practicing psychics in taking special care in how they practice their craft so they might assist in the global shift in consciousness. Introduction. I wonder how many young bucks today qualify to become medicine people. They think in terms of glory. It is not glorious. That is not how I see it. It requires many sacrifices. It is not a glory thing, and it is nothing to brag about. Peter S. Ketches, Lakota Medicine Man. Psychic gifts, like other talents, can be used for positive or negative purposes. Just because a person has psychic gifts doesn't mean they're spiritually evolved. Throughout history, people in a variety of cultures have feared psychics or supersensory persons for good reason. They have always been people who have used their gifts to overpower others. Some people knowingly use their gifts for ill. Some people harm others with their gifts through ignorance. A supersensory person who is not ethical can and often does cause harm. And a psychic who does not intentionally decide to be ethical will very often fail to be ethical. As one well-known 20th century psychic explained it, ESP is a will instrument. All persons having strong wills have a greater capacity to call forth ESP powers. If the will is forceful or selfishly designed, ESP becomes an instrument of destruction. Magicians, charlatans, and fraudsters of various types have often used the pretended display of otherworldly gifts to separate gullible people from their money. And even those who have genuine gifts are sometimes tempted to misuse or exaggerate them in order to make money. Others have used their abilities for more nefarious purposes, to control others, or to unfairly gain advantage over those who lack supersensory abilities. In traditional indigenous cultures throughout the world, instruction in supersensory arts has always been accompanied by instructions for how to be a good person, a good healer, shaman, or medicine person. In the 21st century, non-tribal Western world, most psychics do not get this training, nor do they have the benefit of a dedicated teacher. Instead, developing psychics must often acquire the knowledge they need on their own, by seeking out teachers, courses, and books to enlarge their understanding of their gifts. Because many psychics are self-taught, they are often working without the benefit of instruction in psychical ethics. It is not enough for psychics to learn how to maximize the efficacy of their psychic gifts. They must also learn how to use their gifts for good and never for harm. They must learn how to be ethical psychics. Why we need this book. We are currently living in a shift in consciousness where time is speeding up. People are stepping more firmly onto their paths. More and more people are being born with gifts. And there is greater social acceptance for the expression of these gifts. This is a good thing. It means that there is a mad rush to learn, and to learn fast. Most students are no longer learning in the context of long apprenticeships. They're no longer even seeking face-to-face instruction with revered teachers. They're no longer living in their communities or talking to their elders. Then, too, students are interested in learning about the psychic traditions found in communities and cultures outside of their own. So much transplantation and mixing has occurred between communities and parts of the world that some students don't belong to any one culture or community. They belong to many. Given these circumstances, students have a real need to obtain access to teachings that will help them to develop their gifts in a positive way. While many books exist about how to develop psychic gifts, there is scant mention of ethics in these books, and few books are devoted exclusively to this topic. This book addresses this critical void. What is an ethical psychic? Ethics is the field of philosophy that is concerned with a critical consideration of moral beliefs. As such, it includes a critical and reflective assessment of our beliefs about questions such as, what are the traits of a good person? And what is the right thing to do? This book is concerned with the questions, what are the traits of a good psychic? And what is the right thing to do with one's psychic gifts? An ethical psychic endeavors to be a good person and to do the right thing in his or her practice. An ethical psychic is intentional and conscious in her use of her gifts. She strives to use her gifts to help and never harm, and she takes steps to ensure that no negative consequences result from the expression of her gifts. An ethical psychic does not just seek to do no harm. He consciously and carefully examines all of the possible effects of his work and makes decisions about how to work according to these reflections, doing everything in his power to ensure a positive outcome. Despite his archaic use of language, which equates black with bad and white with good, we can learn from famed scholar of esoterica, Manly P. Hall's definitions of magic in our discernment between ethical and unethical psychics. Hall writes, "The black magician's motto is, might is right, survival of the fittest. The white magician's motto is, right is might, survival of all. Motive is the key to the problem of magic. Even the greatest of white magicians can become a degenerate in an instant if his motives become unworthy. The white magician serves humanity. The black magician seeks to serve himself." Who this book is for? This book is meant to be a resource for all psychics and healers, but especially for those supersensory persons who have not benefited from long study with master teachers who might have provided them with a strong ethical foundation for the practice of their gifts. It is also for students who have teachers. This book is not meant to be a substitution for learning ethics from a teacher. It is meant as an adjunct resource. It is also my hope that the beginning psychic who is developing her craft on her own by reading books and watching videos will come across this book and find it useful for her development, and that the beginning psychic or healer will decide after reading this book that they should work with a teacher. This book will also help that student choose the right teacher. This book is also meant for teachers. It is my hope that teachers of psychic and healing arts can use this as a type of course book for their classes. Both beginning and intermediate courses of psychic instruction would benefit by including this book in their curriculum. Because I am a psychic, a medium, a medical intuitive, an energy healer, and an Akashic records reader, I include examples from all of these practices. Thus, this book is versatile and can be used by teachers and classes teaching a wide variety of intuitive arts. It is my hope, too, that this book will be of use to those individuals who are either in a spiritual community or are thinking about starting one. They can obtain some guidance in this text about how to avoid the unethical behaviors that can lead to the creation of communities centered on fake gurus. This book provides much-needed information for developing psychics and their teachers. In it, the reader will find a description of the traits of an ethical psychic, the unethical risks entailed in doing psychic work, best practices, and a list of frequently asked questions. People who are conscious of the risks.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.